Well, last talk of the day. Anybody has an energy left? Yeah, a little bit. Good. Great. My name is Michel Schudel. I'm a software developer for a Dutch IT company called Craftsman. And I'm going to tell you a little bit today about a nifty little library we encountered called Rest Assured. So, before I begin, I have a question. How many people here are working with REST interfaces on a daily basis? Yeah, quite a lot of you. Good. And about testing these libraries, how are you testing them right now? So, anyone still testing by hand? Still quite a few of you. Okay, maybe this is some exploratory testing or something like that. That's fine. Anyone using SOAP UI? Yeah, a few of you. Postman? Yes. And Cucumber, anyone? So, yeah, quite a few of you. Actually, on our last project, we used Cucumber 2, and it looked something like this. We have a REST service somewhere that is, for example, I have a conference service here that spits out a list of conferences. And to test this service, you have to basically write a feature file and then maybe write some glue code and an HTTP client or whatever. And then you send a request to this service and you get a response and you can do a search, right? So we used this for quite a while and then we found out, well, the feature file is a little bit fragmented and the glue code is all over the place and it's also quite technical. So from a maintainability point of view, it was not quite what we wanted to do. So then we encountered Rest Assured. Anyone already working with it? Yeah, a few of you. Okay, I hope I can tell you something new today. So this is a Java library. It's created by Johan Halleby, and it's been around since 2010, actually. So it's been around for quite a while. And the beauty of the thing is that basically you can just write REST tests as a unit test. So this fits in really well with, for example, your build pipeline, where something like a unit test is something that Jenkins handles really well out of the box. So that's really simple. And you're going to see in a few minutes, it has a very nice BDD style fluent API and actually very powerful response assertions. So checking your response is quite powerful in this library. So to give you a basic idea of what this REST Assured library looks like, it is something like this. You just write a normal unit test, and so annotate it with a test annotation. And basically every REST test in REST Assured has three parts. So given, when, then. So this nice BDD style. In the given part, you set up the request. So if you have to send any parameters, headers, cookies, authentication, or what like, that goes in that part. Then you have the part where you actually execute a request, so a GET or a POST or something like this. You put this in the WHEN clause because this is basically the action you want to take in your BDD style tests. And then in the THEN clause, you can put a lot of assertions or on status code or body assertions or whatever. And so basically all checks that you want to do on a response go in that part. So, well, that's all the slides. Oh, I have one more slide, so I'm going to skip into the demo right now. So I'm going to give a demo, and I have two services basically. One is a conference service, which spits out a list of conferences. So basically DevOps, JFall, GVNCon, and whatnot. And you can access this service with getConference, and then it will spit out a conference. So really simple CRUD-like microservice type thing. There is one other request, which is called getConference with speakers. And this will make a trip to a speaker service. So basically there's a dependency there from the conference service to the speaker service. And I'm going to use this to show you what you can do when your service depends on another and how to step this out. So now I'm going to go to the demo. So let's see, we have a picture here, yeah. So all you need to get this REST Assured library working is this. So it is a nice little Java library, just one Maven dependency or a Gradle dependency if you want to use Gradle. And you basically need to use this. If you want to do something with plugging into the Spring container context, which I'm going to talk about in a little bit, then you also need this one, because the programming model for programming against a traditional Spring MVC application is a little bit different from normal REST assured. But I'm going to talk about this in a few minutes. So one Maven dependency and you're done. So I'm going to show you this service I have. So it's basically very simple. There is a get here with a conference, and it spits out a list of conferences. So of course DevOps is the best Java conference in the world, so I put that first. And the second one we already had like last week, I think, which is if you're ever in the Netherlands and you want to visit a conference, that's a really cool conference, okay? And then of course this is the complete list, and if you have a parameter, for example one, you can get one conference. So this is basically a very simple CRUD conference. Now, if I want to test against this service, for example, let's do a basic check to see if this service actually works, then I can write a unit test. So I have already one prepared here. It is this one. So you see this is a normal unit test, and now I'm going to do a basic setup of REST assured. So what you remember from the slide, so you start with given. From a formatter point of perspective, I'm going to do it like this. So, well, we want to get the list of basic conferences, so I don't need any parameters, headers, cookies, or whatnot. So basically, I can skip the given part and go straight to the when clause. And then I have to execute a request. So, for example, get conference. And then if I get something back, I want to assert something. So I'm going to use then. And then I can assert, well, quite a lot of stuff, as you can see. So for now, I'm only going to do the status code. So if this service is alive or not. Mind you, this service is running externally. So it's not running internally within the test. It's already deployed on the network somewhere. I'm going to show you an example of how to deploy this in container. But for right now, it's running on the network, which is basically now my machine. So I want to test if the status code is 200. That will be a basic test. And maybe we can format this a little bit. So I wanted to have it like this. If anyone knows a good code formatter to in IntelliJ to sense this kind of stuff, that would be really appreciated. I haven't found one yet. So if I'm going to run this, you see it takes quite a while to spin up. It fails miserably because there is a connection refused, and that's because I haven't started the service yet. So that's just one way of showing you, you know, if this thing fails, what it looks like. So now I'm going to start it up. So this is a Spring Boot application, so it should start up pretty quickly. So now it's running. Now I can go back to my unit test. This one, and I can run this. And now it works, right? So this is basically how a basic REST test looks like, what a basic REST test looks like. So I'm going to get this thing out of the way. So now I want to test something extra. For example, I want to see if the response matches with what I expect. So now I can say, for example, body, and then let's see, I want to check if the name is correct of the conference. So the name is what I want. And now's the fun part, you can use a Hamcrest matcher to compare stuff. So for example, something like this. And why doesn't it import? Oh, there it is. No. Yes, fine. Okay. So let's run this. And now you see that it still fails, and it says, everywhere you can read this, Yeah, big enough. It says, JSON path name doesn't match. Expect that DevOps 2017. And actually, get back a list. Well, that's not really strange, because if you don't supply any parameters, you get back the entire list. So this response doesn't match. So it's pretty clear what goes wrong in this case. But in case you want some more extra information, you can also do something like this, that you say, when something comes back, I want to log all stuff that is in the response. Oh, it's not here. Yes, it is here. And I only want to log something if the validation fails. So if the test succeeds, I'm not really interested in all this verbose logging. I only want to have some logging if an error occurs, right? So let me get it out of the way again. So now I basically have, I have log statement. If something goes wrong, log the response, and then proceed to do the other assertions. So if I run this, you see that the same error occurs, but now it also logged the response. So you have some more information on how to fix this test. So now I'm going to fix this test. And one way I can get to this list is do something like this, name zero. So it will now take the first object in the list and take the name attribute of that. This is green, but this is not very nice, right? Because I don't know the order in which the conferences come in. So what I want to know is the DevOps conference in there. So what I can do, for example, is remember this works on a list, and now I can say, you know, on this list, just do a has items Hamcrest matcher. And if I run this, it should be green, because one of the name attributes in the object is the DevOps conference. So this is green. But what I can also do is I can write a Groovy closure. For example, let's see, this one. Oh. And this is Groovy closure that says, you know, for all conferences in this list, take the name attribute and only take those ones, filter those ones that start with the letter D, and take the names from that. So this will still give me a list, but only the list of conferences that start with a D. So this will have the same result as my assertion earlier. So this is really powerful, these Groovy closures. I'll show you that works, but you can trust me on this. So it's still green, and this response assertion is really powerful. Also, you can change stuff. So if I go to the next line, you can write a new assertion and just have as many assertions as you want, right? So this is a basic request. What I can also do is supply parameters. So I'm going to copy this for a moment. So now I only want to have one conference, conference number one. So how do you apply parameters? Well, I already told you that in the given clause, you could set up the request. So I'm going to write here. So given param, let's see, ID with number one. And the URL is still the same. Then I should be able to retrieve the name. And of course, now it is not a list anymore. It's now just an object. So this goes back to equal to. And this still works. So this is a way to supply parameters to an HTTP request. And now you can ask yourself, is this a query parameter or is this a form parameter? So what rest assured does is, if it's a GET, it will supply a query parameter. And if it's a POST, it will supply a form parameter automatically. So this is pretty handy, but you can also force it if you want to deviate from this. So you can also do like something like a query param or a form param and just force it to be a specific kind of parameter. So path parameters are also supported. So you can do path parameter, and then you can say, okay, I'm going to insert a path parameter here. Yeah. And this also works. You can also inline them. So do something like this and just leave this out. And this will also work. So this is the one goes to the ID and it's still a path parameter. So you've seen me type already quite a few things repeatedly. So you can also reuse stuff. For example, if I'm going to say, I always want to check if the status code is 200, I can write something called a request builder. There it is. And now I can say in my setup request spec builder dot set status code. So sorry, expect state. No, this should be response spec builder. I'm sorry. And also this one. Like this. And now I can say, of course, this has to be this. And now I can say expect status code 200 and then use this request spec status code instead of this. And I can say spec response spec builder dot build. And then I can leave this out. So, of course, now I only have the status code specified, so it is really useless in this case. But what you can do is put more stuff on this and reuse that. So there's a lot more on this, like expect content type, expect body. So everything that is basically your common assertion, you can put in here and reuse for every test method. Okay, and let's see a little bit about posting. You can also post, of course, to this service, a new conference. So what you do is you can insert a, for example, a JSON object. This is new conference. And then say when, sorry, in this case, I have to supply a payload, of course. So now I'm going to say given body conference when post not post conference then spec response spec builder. So I'm dot build. So I'm only going to check the let's format this for a moment. Now I'm going to only check the status code, but you're going to see that it will actually store something. So if I run this, it will fail. And this is because the Spring Boot application says, no, sorry, 415. Does anybody know what 415 is? Nobody? Media type, yeah. Exactly. So what Spring Boot application does is, if you don't supply any media type definition, it will only accept application JSON. So I have to supply this as well. Well, I already told you that in the given part, you can specify your requests. So what you can do is, for example, say here, header. I think I have a shortcut for that. Because you don't want to see me type all day. And our value application JSON, yeah, that should be it. Now it's green. There are also for content type, there's actually a shortcut. So you can also do something like this, yeah? So that's shorter. Let's see. Yes, I've created a JSON object here. But instead of a JSON object, you can also just make a plain old Java object. So, for example, I have a conference here, which is a plain old Java object. You can delete this. And what rest assured will do is when it detects a plain old Java object, it will try to apply. If Jackson is on the class path, it will try to convert it to JSON. And if JaxB is on the class path, it will attempt to convert it to an XML message. So you have to be, you can also force this, but if you don't specify anything, whatever is found first on the class path, it will use that. So this is a way to, so you don't have to change anything in your test setup. And of course, you can also extract stuff. So if I want to say, I want to reuse the ID that comes back because this post returns the object with an ID after it's stored in the database, you can say something like extracts path, and then I want the ID of the objects. And then, of course, I have to assign it to something. So int ID is like that. And then I can reuse that to do a normal get. By the way, you can also skip syntactic sugar. So you can also do this immediately, like here. Maybe not this one, or maybe it's just an import issue. Well, I'll skip that for now. When get, so now I'm going to just skip the given part. Conference, then, of course, with an ID. So I'm going to specify path parameter. And status code 200. So this is a way to reuse stuff you get from your response. And it's still green. So I got the idea back and I can reuse this to get the request. So this is basic REST testing. So nothing really fancy here, but what happens if you want to try to integrate this into a Spring Boot project, for example? So if you build a Spring Boot REST integration tests. Let me get this out of the way again. So this is the way you start a Spring Boot test, so nothing fancy there. But of course, when Spring Boot starts, a Spring Boot test starts, it will deploy a Spring Boot service on your local network. So it will deploy an external artifact. So there's nothing new here. I can just use the same REST request I already had. So nothing new here. The only thing is it will now spin up on a random port. So I'm gonna, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stop. Oh, not that one. I'm gonna stop my running service for a moment. So it's still running here, I think. Yeah. And if I run this. So now it's spinning up the Spring Boot service. It fails, and that's because it says connection refused. And anyone know why that is in this case? Yeah, the port. So what's, what I have here is that Spring spins up on a random port, so I have to know this port. Well, fortunately, Spring Boot has a utility for that, so that you can inject the port. So something like this, and then you can say given port this port, and then it uses the port that is configured in the Spring Boot test framework. So if you run this, you see, of course, this is an IT test. This is, so this takes a little longer to spin up. And now it works. So that's a way to integrate REST Assured into a Spring Boot application. So it's really simple. If you want to, let's see, do this in a more traditional way, in a traditional Spring application context, you can also do this. But this programming model is a little different. So let's see. I think this is the one, yeah. So it is a basic Spring application context, and now I'm going to plug into the container. So the first thing I need is a an application context, which I'm going to inject here. And then I have to tell REST Assured to use this application context. So I think it's here, yeah. Web context setup. Like this. Now, REST Assured is connected to the Spring container, and you have to tear it down as well. So you have to also reset. And now I can write a REST test, but you have to start with another class, namely REST Assured Mock MVC, which ties into the Spring container. You can use the same programming model with a few small exceptions, but this is basically the same way. So I'm not gonna finish this request, but so basically it is tying into the web application context REST Assured Mock MVC, and then you can use this to tie in a traditional Spring container and run your REST Assured test from there, right? So the last thing I wanted to show you is remember the speaker service that my service depended on. So I have to stub this out. So I'm going to stub it out now with a tool called WireMock. And what it does is you basically specify a dummy response. So I'm going to insert this here. So this is a response using a JSON array. And this responds to what my service is expecting. So this is only building the response definition. And now, of course, I'm going to have to set up WireMock as well. So I do this like this. I start a new WireMock service in my integration test, and I'm going to start it. And I specify with WireMock service top 4 that it will should return this dummy response. And I have to tear down it as well. With a stop. And then, of course, one thing is missing because I have no speaker endpoint. So I have to get the speaker endpoint that is configured in the Spring Boot application because it is connecting to a port for the speaker service. So thankfully, I can get that. So I can do it like this. So now I get the value that is configured in the Spring Boot application, and I can reuse it. And now I can just write a normal unit test again, and let's see if this actual speaker information comes back from the speaker service through my conference service. So I'm going to run that. I think there might be a typo. Still, let's see. Oh, there was the one that I stopped. Yeah, sorry. It was this one, right? So this runs, and now it will start a Spring Boot application with a WireMock stub configured behind it, so it can talk to the stub service. And I get back a response. It is green, and you can see here that the speaker, the conference service now has a connection to my dummy WireMock that I configured in this integration test. So this is a great way to stub out responses on dependencies you might depend on, right? So that is the demo. I'm gonna switch back for a moment. So what really helped us is rest assured, it's very short. It's very good to read. It has a fluent API, and we finally got rid of all these, feature files and glue code and stuff. This is all contained within REST Assured. So this really helped us to tidy up our REST tests in our last project. So we're very happy with that. And that's the end of my talk. So thank you very much for attending. You can find REST Assured here. If you want to play around with it, it's on my GitHub. So try that. I have very little time left, so as far as Q&A is concerned, I know you're pretty tired probably, so I don't like to hold the audience hostage. But if you have any questions, come up to me and I'll be try to answer them. So that's my talk. Thank you for attending and enjoy the rest of the conference. Thank you.